I did it. I got my first web developer job. Let's talk about it. So if you clicked on this video, I'm sure you've thought about web development and how to get into it. Well, you know, some people go to school, some people self-study, some people go through a boot camp. The way I did it was through self-study and through a type of boot camp, kind of. It was through the Udacity program, which I do have a video on and I've reviewed it. But really, it comes down to your skills and your projects. I learned HTML, CSS, JavaScript, jQuery, Bootstrap, Adobe Illustrator, Adobe Photoshop, some InDesign too, and how to shoot photography and video and do personal branding. And those are really my core skills. And I just self-studied a lot. I did books, I did Pluralsight, I did, let's see, what else did I do? I did lynda.com, Team Treehouse, just all these online resources, as well as a lot of offline resources, a lot of books. So that really taught me how to do HTML and CSS. And actually, I learned all of that before I learned design. I was using a program called Corel or Corel Draw, which is great, but there's not as much information out there as there is with Adobe's products, Adobe Photoshop and all that stuff. There's tons of information out there. And that's how I really got started. After that, I just started building up my personal brand, doing a lot of projects, did my website over multiple times, learned Bootstrap, did projects with using like APIs. So I would take some JavaScript, it would make a request, and then with the information that came back, it would come in what's called an array. You can learn about that later, but I would take the array, take the information, and then reorganize it to get specific data. So I've done a lot of, you know, projects like that, but it really comes down to completing your projects, how good they are. That's it. Like, the cool thing about web development is you don't need a degree, but you have to study and you do have to be educated. You know, you don't necessarily have to go into computer science, although I would recommend it if you could. But you know, those are the skills that I learned. But why did I get into web development? What pushed me that way? Well, I was in a job that I really, I wasn't passionate about, and there was no way up. I stayed there for 2 years. And after seeing other employees moving up, I realized that, you know, it's probably not for me, this company, just because either I didn't have the right personality or the right skills. But it wasn't that I was hard to get along with or anything like that. It just wasn't the right fit for me. So I decided to study. I studied graphic design, and that's primarily what I started out with. And actually, I started out with a book. It's up here. Give me just a minute to grab it. This is like the first book, the OG, that got me into all of this. It was, you can learn how to draw. Whoops. You can learn how to draw in 30 days. So, no, that was right. You can learn how to draw in 30 days. Sorry. And from there, I just learned more about graphic design theory, history, and moved into web development. And I do it in all of my spare time, and the time came to make a decision. Am I going to get serious with this? Is it just something that I can, you know, kind of do on the side? But I decided to go serious and take time off, 5 months in fact, to study web development through the Udacity Nanodegree. And it was really the best thing I've done. After that, I didn't have a job yet, but I did have a few inquiries, and I had a few people I had to turn down. Not just for web development, but some was for customer service for some really cool companies like Pluralsight. But, you know, what happened was I saw a job here in town for a social media manager. And I thought, that's a great way to learn graphic design. And it was. And so I just worked hard, learned all of I could about graphic design, photography, all of that, and, you know, how social media works. And then just kept on working on my projects. I made a few web development projects and incorporated that Photoshop in there so you could do the whole design and front end. Now, I don't know the back end yet. I'll be doing that later. But that's really how I got my job, just putting my branding out there, making completed projects, and then going to interviews and really knowing what I'm talking about. So one of the interview questions I had was, are you familiar with C# or ASP.NET? Now, I'm not yet. But I was able to know enough to say, you know, I'm not familiar with a lot of those Microsoft those Microsoft languages or frameworks. And so that shows that I'm in the know. I know what they are, and I'm in the web development world, and I keep up on it. So that's really how I did it. Now, going forward, I'm going to do these every week, and I have a new intro, so check it out. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments, and I'll try to answer them as best I can. I'll be going forward, again, just talking about my experiences, what I'm learning, what I have to learn, what challenges I come across, and that's it. Thanks for watching. Oh, and remember to always be learning. Keep it real. See ya.